in the previous sessions we have discussed about TestNG. We are discussing about TestNG. We have installed TestNG, then we have came to know what are the annotations in TestNG, what are the annotations in TestNG, and if you have many array test annotations in TestNG, by default it will run in alphabetical order. By default it will run in alphabetical order. By default order. In this, whatever it is there in alphabetical order, if you rearrange, we can go with prioritize. If any method, then sorry, using enabled equal to false. Then we have used depends on methods. Then we have saw assertions, skipping, all these things we have saw. Right. This is what we have saw in the previous sessions. Now, let me create one more TestNG class and try to run that. Right click, run as TestNG test. Right click, run as TestNG test. Now if I run this, it will run users. It will run create user, edit user and delete user. It will run create user, edit user and delete user. Create user, edit user and delete user. In this case, if I want to run an individual class, for example, if I want to run customers, I can right click on the customers, run as TestNG test. Create customer, edit customer and delete customer. If I want to edit. Now, in the same way, if I want to right click TestNG, create TestNG class. I'm going to create another TestNG class. I'll name this as user. Sorry, not user is already there. Then let me name this as report. Here I'm going to create report. System.out.println create report. Then delete report. Delete report. Now, likewise, I have something, create report, delete report, like that. Now, if I run this reports, right click, run as TestNG test. Run as test. Create report and delete report. Create report and delete report. Now, if I have reports, if you have as a report, then I can, if I want to run the reports, I am right click, I can do right click on reports, run as TestNG test. If I want to run users, I will do right click, run as TestNG test. If I want to run customers, I can run right click, run as TestNG test. But my goal is, I need to run all three I have to run, which is there inside the package. Whatever which is there inside the package, all these three classes I have to run one after the other continuously in the same order. Then how can I do that? If I do right click on the package, run as TestNG test. Run as TestNG test. Then here, create user, user reports and customers. User reports and customers. It is running in some reverse order or random order or something. But it is not running in the same order like customers, customers, users, customers, reports and users. But I don't want like that. If I run the package, right click, all the classes which are there inside the package, it is running, but it is not running in the same order. It is not running in the same order. But I don't want the output like that. What I need the output. Now, I am talking about the classes inside the package. Until now, we have discussed about how to rearrange the methods inside the class. Whatever the methods are there, how to rearrange that, we have solved by using priority or sequencing or some other thing. But now, we are moving one step ahead, one step upper. We are going to see how to run the how to run the TestNG classes in a particular sequence. How to do that? That is what we are going to see now. How to do that? That is what we are going to see now. Now, what I am going to do in that case, now, now, what I have to do in that case, I need to do XML. In that case, create an XML and mention customer.xml first. Customer.xml first. Report.xml next. And user.xml next. User.xml next. XML. Customers, reports, and users like that. Customers, reports, and users. In that case, how to customers, reports, and you create an XML. Arrange the .java file. Arrange the Java files in a particular sequence. Then run the XML. Then run the XML. Then run the XML so that it will run as per that order. It will run as per that particular order. How to do that? That is what we are going to see now. Right? Now, how to create XML? XML, the purpose of XML is to arrange the .java files in a particular sequence and then to run. Now, in that case, how to create a, when, see, before learning XML, I am going to teach you one small topic here. Normally, how will you open temp folder in your machine? Percentage temp percentage you will give and you will hit enter. All the temp files will be located there. When your system becomes slow, I will select all and I will delete everything. If I delete everything, right, then it will get deleted and our system becomes quite fast. That is why we delete normally. Delete for sure. Okay, now this is everything got deleted here. Is there any folder called TestNG? No, I don't find any folder called TestNG here. But when I run any TestNG class or a package, right click, run as TestNG test. If I run this, see, when I come back to this, see, a folder called TestNG has been created. If I run this once again, click run as TestNG test. Right click, run as TestNG test. Create, edit, delete. Same way, see, one more got created. Each and every, if I run the package also, one folder called TestNG gets created. Right click, run as TestNG test. Why I am telling you this in the sense, TestNG test, why I am telling you this in the sense, when you run any class or a package, the stem folder will keep on getting filled and your system will become slow. That's why try to delete this frequently. Try to delete this frequently so that it will get deleted. So that it will get deleted. This is how to do that. Now it got deleted. Everything gets deleted. Okay. Got deleted. Now my goal is to, if I run the package, it is running all the .java files which is there inside, all the testng .java files which is there inside the package, but it is running in some random order. But I don't want to run that in that random order. I need to create an XML, keep all the names of the .java files in that XML and run the XML files. How to create the XML files? Clearly listen. Now, first right click on the package, run as testng test. Right click on the package, run as testng test. Now what happens? Users is getting created, reports is getting executed and customers is getting executed next. When you come back here, I don't want in that order. Now go to temp folder. Inside this, a folder called testng gets created, right? Go inside this. There is a XML file which got created automatically. When you open that XML, this is the default XML. Right click, open this XML in the notepad. It will run in some random order. First it is executing users, then it is executing reports, then it is executing customer. It is running in some different order. It is running in some different order. In that case, click open with. It is running in some different order. Users rip. Now what I am going to do, this will be generated when you click on the package and run that. When you open the temp folder, you will be getting this. I am going to copy this and paste it to the project. Go to source. First it is getting users, then reports, then customers. In that case, what I am going to do here, realtor. Copy it. Customers, reports, and users. Customer, report, and users. Now, right click on the customers, run as testng suite. First it is executing customer, then it is executing reports, then it is executing users. Reports and users. It is getting executed customers, reports and users. Now rearrange the order. Very easy. When you run any package, a default XML will be created. Copy that XML, paste it here and change that order and run that XML so that it will run in this order. Now what F2 is to rename. I am going to name this as functionality. That is how I need to create the XML. Now, if I want to run only customers and users, I don't want to run reports. In that case, I can remove this. But tomorrow again, if I want to do that, then that makes a problem. That's why what I can do is I can create one more XML. I can create one more XML. How to create one more XML? How to create one more XML? Right click on the run as, sorry, right click on the package, sorry, right click on the package. First create the clear the temp folder, clear everything which is there inside the temp folder, or else you will get mess up. Right click on the package, run as test ng test, then the temp folder, an XML will be created. Copy that XML file from the temp folder and paste it into the project. Right click, paste it, then do the changes whatever you want. Go here, I want to run only customers and users, I don't want to run reports. In that case, customers and reports. I'm going to name this as smoke testing. Customers and reports. That's it. This is all about how to XML. Yes, now if I run this smoke.xml, right click, run as test ng suit. Create customer, edit customer and delete customer, create user. That's it. This is the purpose of XML. If you want to execute multiple test ng classes in a particular sequence, then we need to create an XML. How to create an XML? Right click on the package, run as test ng test. Each time an individual test ng class or a package is created, it will create an default XML in the temp folder. Copy that XML file from the temp folder and paste it into the project folder. Paste it into the project. And just double click on this, edit that and change as per the order and run it. That is what. That is all about TestNG XML. TestNG topic is done now. This is the leftover topic in TestNG. We have done with TestNG now. Guys, everyone, have you understood this? Yes, okay. I'm going to implement these things going further, that's why. Creating TestNG XML. If you want to execute multiple TestNG classes in a particular sequence, then we need to create an XML. Procedure, right click on the package, run as TestNG test. Each time an individual TestNG class or a package is executed, TestNG creates an XML in the temp folder. Copy the XML file from the temp folder. In Eclipse, right click on the project and paste it. Edit the XML as per the order and run the XML files. That's it. Take note of this.